for the headbutt. Low blow, back of the head and spine.
And the Greco-Roman wrestling of Akhmatov. Already seeking a takedown and gets it.
Nice little catch to a takedown there from Khairat Akhmatov as he lands in half guard. Let's see what King Ag can do off of his back right now. Khairat's very strong in this position. He's got very heavy hips, exceptional ground and pound, and he chooses his shots very carefully.
What are the options here for Danny King Ag?
Well, first thing Danny King Ag's got to do, he's got to try to get off his back. He's got to turn onto his side and start looking for an underhook. See how he's trying to take his right hand and kind of shove it in? He's looking to get an underhook on his right side so he can pop himself onto his side and create some movement. But Khairat's so heavy. Decades of wrestling from Khairat Akhmatov. They're going to try to keep him flat on his back so he can't go anywhere. The thing about the half guard is all about movement. You got to try to get onto your side and create that movement.
Khairat Akhmatov, who says he has to dominate the fight because the judges always favor Danny King Ag, says he can't take any chances.
Good job by King Ag to get back into full guard. Yeah, Danny King Ag has a pretty, really good track record as far as decisions go. He knows how to rack up points and secure decision wins.
Well, Akhmatov thought that King Ag definitely lost against Rhys McLaren, but said King Ag was gifted a decision. He does not want this to go to the judges tonight. He wants to finish the business before the 15 minutes.
I don't think it was gifted. I just think Danny King Ag, like Team Lakai in general, they know how to score. They know the scoring of one championship because they've been involved since the beginning.
You know that wasn't me that said that, right? That was Khairat that said it was a gift. Just to clarify.
Good top control
here of King Ag.
Good top control coming from Khairat Akhmatov. This is what he wants. He wants to keep King Ag on his back, beat him up for the duration of this match. He does not want King Ag on his feet, flowing with that strike and hitting him with that wushu. King Ag actually spent time training with the Philippine National Kickboxing Team, so his striking is real sharp, and King Ag and Akhmatov knows that. And he wants to ground him, put him on his back, beat him up, and make him work. Drain that energy, that explosiveness away from Danny King Ag, and do this. Nice little elevation here from King Ag.
Dragon that characterizes a Greco-Roman wrestler.
Greco-Roman wrestling is attacks from the upper body.
So no attacks below the waist, right?
Yeah, they don't attack the legs.
So it's a tremendous upper body strength.
Exactly. That's why he's so good inside the clinch. When you see Khairat inside that clinch, he manhandles people. But this time, he was able to get the match to the ground by catching the kick and then putting King Ag down. And King Ag hasn't been able to go anywhere.
And this is the game plan being worked to perfection so far for Khairat Akhmatov, the former flyweight champion of the world.
I spoke to Rhys McLaren about Khairat Akhmatov, and McLaren was like, Akhmatov is so strong. He never really felt that pressure from somebody at this weight. He's just so powerful and controlling. It's really hard to deal with him. And that's why King Ag's not really able to do much. He created a little bit of space there by kicking off, but Khairat immediately scooted in and kept that pressure on.
Akhmatov believes the winner of this one should be the number one contender for Adriano Moraes' world title. He has fought Moraes twice. He was the one who ended Moraes' first reign, but then, of course, lost the second match and lost the world title to Adriano. Has gone 4-1 since then on a three-fight win streak with love a trilogy match against the champion.
Good ground control. Khairat's doing a lot of the right stuff. You know, he's got his feet on the hips, he's trying to push away. He's just got to be a little bit faster with that push and getting his back on the wall so he can pop back up.
What was Olivia trying to do there with the foot of Danny?
I think King Ag's foot got caught on the cup, and I think it was just trying to unhook it a little bit there from the shorts there of Khairat.
Feet on hips here from Danny King Ag. Tries to. So you're trying to pass the side control there, Khairat Akhmatov?
Yeah, he's pretty close to doing it, but King Ag's got a good guard. I'm surprised King Ag has been able to maintain this guard the entire time they've been on the ground. Khairat's got great guard passing, and there is a little bit of space. He's trying to get his back on the wall so he can get back up, but still Khairat with that pressure, and he's going to be able to end the round here, it looks like.
Danny needs to get back into it. Stand-up position, and the round ends. A loss to the champion, Adriano Moraes, very early on in his career. King Ag would love that rematch. As I said earlier, Akhmatov would love a trilogy match against the champ. Moraes coming up a win earlier this year where he knocked out Demetrius Johnson.
Defense.
on our one on TNT series.
This is that clinch position. Let's see what Kairo can do with it. Whereas Danny's got two underhooks, and he's trying to pry him up. He was able to turn him around. That's good for King Ad.
And Danny, get the left arm free to work those strikes. No chance to throw the knees. He drops down looking for a single leg. Roundhouse kick there from Karadakhmatov.
Nice combination thrown by Kairat on the exit there from the break off of the clinch.
Kairat did say he was not afraid to stand and trade with Danny King.
Now we've seen Kairat stand and trade with Jehei Eustaquio, with Adriano Marias. We saw him do it with Daehwan Kim. Kairat's got very good striking, but he prefers to lean on his wrestling, and I think he's probably going to do that here. Nice little catch there by King Ad as he rushes forward with a big uppercut.
Well, we see Danny looking for a takedown here in the second round. Is that where you thought he'd go here, Mitch?
Well, I believe that Danny King Ad thinks that Kairat is not as good on his back as he is on top, and I think that's what he's trying to initiate here, because now King Ad gets taken down with a beautiful duck under there. It was a huge windup off that right hand. Kairat saw it come in, ducked underneath it beautifully.
Butterfly hooks here from Danny King Ad, glances over to his corner for a moment. Mark Sangiao calling the instructions. Will Akhmatov look to pass here? Both men not breathing heavily, plenty left in the gas tank. They're not known for gassing out, either of them. Should be fine to go the full 15 minutes here. Single butterfly hook for Danny King Ad. There's a lot of instructions coming from Karat's corner. What do you think they're saying to him over there, Dragon?
Well, if he's following their instructions, they're saying push down on that left leg, work into half guard, and then slowly try to get back in. But King Ad's good scrambling, right? King Ad is, we've seen that time and time again from King Ad. He's got great movement. And as Kairat was able to try to push down on that leg, King Ad was still able to keep that butterfly guard.
Some heavier breathing coming into play, and you wonder if it's Danny King Ad, because like you said earlier on when we saw Murad Ramazanov against Kadastan, this style of wrestling is grinding, and it drains you, and it saps you of every ounce of energy.
Yeah, it's like trying to push against a brick wall, pushing as hard as you can against that wall, and it doesn't move. It's going to be draining, and not only physically, but also mentally. It demoralizes you, and it's just hard to deal with. And when somebody, they just keep coming, and that's what Kairat's bringing to this, is his game plan is being executed perfectly.
Is this the right defense from Danny, the butterfly guard?
Well, it's kind of all that Kairat's given him, right? Like, he could try to put his feet on the hips like he did in the first and then push off, but it's so hard when you're dealing with a grappler, the capability of Kairat. I'd like to see him dig for an underhook right there. See, now he's got the underhook. Now we can create that space. That was a good job by King Ad. He's got the underhook, but still, Kairat is so heavy on top. You can see the way Kairat just kind of floats on top. That's decades of experience. It's really hard to train for.
Don't forget, folks, once again, Karadakhmatov said he does not want this to go to the judges. He believes the judges always favor Danny King Ad. He wants to finish the Filipino.
Well, if he continues with a performance like this, like in the next 5 minutes and 45 seconds, it's going to be pretty much academic, because King Ed's not able to mount any offense off of his back here.
But is this enough of a performance to send a message to Adriano Marias, Dragon?
That's a tough call, especially, you know, when you've got, you know, so many contenders inside, you know, the flyweight division. And it is a good move up. You know, if he takes out the number two guy, you know, that's a pretty big statement right there, right?
Good popping right hand to the side of the jaw there from Akhmatov.
10 seconds, watch out back of the head.
Another one watch there out. From Karat. Final seconds of this second round. We're going to move into the third. And once again, it is judged as an overall contest. Now, Dragons.
Well, he's got to keep it on the feet. I'd like to see him start going after the leg kicks. Maybe start going a little bit lower, hard for Kairat to pick that up as far as the takedown is concerned. But you can see him, he's going for it.
Yeah, it's a bit of the wushu technique coming in now, trying to mix it up. Danny King over the jumping roundhouse. Good punch to takedown there from Akhmatov.
Yeah, that was a beautiful left hand to a single. Was able to get him down again, and this is right back to where we ended minute 10, and we're seeing it right back here as Kairat is able to settle back down into position, get into the guard of King Ed and start working on him. You asked me about possibly, you know, what's gonna happen next for Kairat. If it's not Adriano Moraes, I wouldn't mind seeing him going up against DJ.
Oh, that'd be thrilling. That would be thrilling. And you know, we can see that Danny is having difficulty, but he knew this was coming, Dragon.
Yeah, 100%. I mean,
there's no other way you could prepare for Kairat. You know this is what Kairat's going to do. It's not like Kairat Akhmatov is ever full of surprises. It's just that what he does so well.
Yeah, and especially against primarily a striker, right? Shutting down their striking game, keeping them on their back, and just applying that suffocating pressure, right? See, look, Danny's got an underhook, right? He's got an underhook on the right side. He's on his side, right? And there's still nothing he can do, right? If you're getting coached by, you know, from your coach, from your corner, they're telling you to do this. He might be able to turn into a single.
Sprawls out here to Zakhmatov. A little bit of the tape coming loose on the left glove of the former world champion. That tango on the feet foot knee landed there by Danny Kinnaird. Chance of the elbows. There it is. That's more like it. And Olivier sees ready? That tape that comes loose, rips it off. We're back underway. Can Danny keep it striking in the wushu realm and work his magic? He's got to stay on his feet, Danny Kinnaird. He cannot go to ground against Kairat Akhmatov. He tagged him. Uppercut, follow punch, another one. You see Danny Kinnaird, desperation now. He wants to land that big salvo, that one big shot that may drop Kairat Akhmatov. And it's not beyond the realm of possibility for Danny Kinnaird to do that.
Yeah, I like how he starts going to the uppercuts too to deter that shot. I want to see the knees. I want to see the uppercuts coming from Akinya. You can see him threatened there with the uppercut. Look at him.
This is the danger time now for Kairat Akhmatov with 2:20 remaining because Danny Kinnaird's confidence is building. The longer it stays on its feet, some knees on the inside here from the King.
Kinnaird's got to separate here. He's not going to do it right here. He just don't want to tangle in the clinch with Kairat, even though he's got the underhooks on both sides.
Don't forget the Greco-Roman wrestling, known for its upper body strength, which is what Mitch is talking about. You've got to get out of this situation. Break off. Work the distance for the wushu strikes.
Looks like Kairat might be fatigued a little bit. He's not even pummeling in. He's just kind of sitting there with it. Kinnaird needs to separate. Get back to those uppercuts. Get back to the striking.
1:45 time against Danny Kinnaird.
Kairat has built up so much of a lead with just his aggression on the ground and his top control.
Watch out, watch out, watch out.
Hawking knee to the inside thigh there. Akhmatov says, okay, boss, no worries. It didn't hit me in the groin. Another knee there from Kinnaird. Right idea. Love to see him get the right arm free and crack an elbow across the jaw of Akhmatov. But there's no separation here, Dragon.
Yeah, I don't know if it's because Kinnaird's not letting go or Kairat's not letting him give him that space, but this is good for Kairat Akhmatov to just sort of ride out the round here. Kinnaird's got to separate. I don't know why he's trying to take him down.
1 minute left. Trying to guess the game plan here of Danny Kinnaird with 56 seconds remaining in their last fight of 2021. Team Philippines leading the world 2-1, but Kairat Akhmatov having a very good 10 minutes of this fight, and now he's back on top and he's inside control.
Oh, that was beautiful timing from Kairat Akhmatov to catch the knee like that and to turn around and put him on his back.
Will Danny rue a missed opportunity on the feet to not have broken off and worked the striking that was looking better in this round?
Possibly. He might regret it, but he also gave him a little bit of time to maybe he was tired, but I don't know what he was thinking at that point in time, but Kairat Akhmatov showing the veteran that he is and really putting together a good display here, trying to work that ground and pound from the top position.
10 seconds. Wow, how about the grunting of Kairat Akhmatov? Put a bow on that. And there's the sportsmanship and the goodwill. Rightfully so.
Blue corner, Kairat.